Hi guys, it's Dr. Muhammad Usman and I am back with another video. If you haven't liked my YouTube channel, do visit my YouTube channel and like and subscribe to my YouTube channel to stay updated. You can also visit my Facebook page for updates. So let's talk about today's topic. So today I will be talking about business writing skills. In this video, we'll be talking about types of business communication and what is business communication. And furthermore, this will be the foundational video of business writing skills. Later on, we will be moving into the advanced phase of business writing and we'll be talking about what are different features and models in business writing. So first of all, if we start from the business communication definition, we will say that the communication is the way of transferring information and understanding from one to one or one to many users. Like if you are talking to a single person, then you are transferring the communication or doing the communication one to one person. And if you are teaching to different many people, then you are doing communication from one to many person. It could be in place of verbal or written mode. Verbal mode is like if you are speaking with that person, then it is a verbal mode. Written mode is like if you are writing on the paper, it is a written mode. And you can use both of the verbal and written form when you are talking to a person or when you are working on a work. There are different types of communications like face-to-face meetings, group discussions, email writing, and even non-verbal modes like gestures, body language, and the way of talking or walking. All of these are counted in the business communication. And communication model consists of a sender and a receiver. So as a sender, when you are writing a message, you are going to send through a channel. That channel can be verbal or non-verbal, and that channel can have the message in a written form or in just an audio form if you are talking a person from face to face. The other person has to read that message and understand that message if it is written in form. And other way, if the other person is listening to you, then the other person will try to understand that message. So the message will be decoded at the receiver end. So if the understandability of the receiver matches your understandability, then the message will be easily conveyed and the receiver will give you the feedback like he or she understand your message. But if the compatibility or understanding is not equal or to each other, then the receiver will be telling you that I didn't understood the message. This normally happens in our life when we are talking to a different person and we are not able to communicate. But when we are talking about business communication, we have to communicate properly and we have to communicate in a manner that every different user understand what are your business needs and what your business is going to communicate or convey to them. So moving forward into the business communication, it is a form of communication that involves communicating for business for any official purpose. This can be your resume, this can be your CVs, this can be your email, website, and frequently asked questions. So whether you are displaying your business in form of an email or website, or you are individually displaying yourself in form of a CV or resume, this is a form of a business communication. The letters you get, the newsletters, the brochures, the articles, the catalog, and similarly like the advertisement, pamphlets, presentations, report, manuals, proposal, books, every form that is from a company, organization, or person to person for a service or a product selling purpose is called business communication. So every business communication has a predetermined objective. Like if you are sending your resume to an organization, you will have the objective to get the job. And similarly, like if an organization is displaying advertisements, pamphlets, signs, the communication aim is to get and sell their products. So they are going to get the customers by selling their products. When we are talking about business communication, there are three different important types of communication as I discussed in the starting. Number one is the verbal communication, second is the written communication, and third is the non-verbal communication. We'll be looking into each of them in detail. First of all, when we are talking about verbal communication, it is the instant feedback communication. When you are talking to another person on phone, call, or face to face, it is called verbal communication. It is also opportunity to check for understanding because you can ask that other person if you are understanding the message or not. And if the person is not understanding the message, you can convey and communicate the message back. On the third note, it involves questioning and paraphrasing and foster closure or open items. If you are the person is in front of you, many things you can clarify with them and it is a faster form of the communication. and there is no record unless there are meeting minutes. So basically, when you are talking to a person, you are not recording your communication, so it will be having no record, and it will be increasing the speed of the communication. So verbal communication is the very first way every user try to convey to other person, like talking to that person in form of any forms of communication that involves just speaking or talking to that person. This can be in form of group meetings or meetings we usually do, or in the interviews, that is also verbal communication. The second type is the written communication. The written communication is the communication where you will be not present to tell about yourself or your product or service. It can be in form of a record for future reference. It is properly structured, properly checked, and properly inspected before going and launching into the market. It is a tool to gain attention, like presentations are one form of written communication with bullets, bolds, and graphics. It has the ability to provide you further details of the communication and items which cannot be provided in verbal communication. As written communication is a recorded form, the user will be having a greater time to understand that thing and to research on that item. It is mostly used for more formal type of communication, like job description letters and your different letters from the organization, your admission letters, your certificates. These are all form of written communication. It has many different forms, like it can have diagrams, pictures, graphs, reports, policies, agreements, and it can be comprehensive and accurate. Written communication is also in form of your thesis and projects, which are writtenly communicated, and your reports are also in these forms. The third form, and which is the least effective form, is the non-verbal communication. But I will say that in business communication, when we are talking to another person and we can get the non-verbal clue, it can tell us that whether the other person is going to give us contract or not, and whether the other person is interested in our product or service. It is like consisting of different physical signs and symbols. It can be good symbols, it can be bad symbols, but in form of business communication, we have to focus on the good symbols. It complements the verbal communication, and it helps you to analyze that what other person is conveying to you. Like a person talking to you and the person is moving his hands, and if the person arms are crossed, and if the person is standing on one leg or bending his leg. So basically, you can select different non-verbal communication items that can convey you what other person is thinking about you. And we can say that non-verbal communication, the gestures talk more than the words. Basically, a person can lie from the tongue, but a body language cannot lie to the other person. It can be positive or negative, and it can indicate the person's personality. So basically, up to here we have discussed the non-verbal communication and the verbal communication, the written communication, and the definition of business communication. I hope so you have liked this video. So this video was up to here. If you like my video, do visit my YouTube channel and like and subscribe to it. You can also earn training certificate from our video channel. The process is as follows, and it is easy for you. We have issued many certificates for many participants, and you can also get special certifications. So what you are waiting for? Go today to my YouTube channel and like and subscribe to it. Thank you.